I'd like to begin by quoting a hadith. All the hadith I'm going to quote right now from the chapter of Ikhlas and Sincerity, which is compiled by Imam al-Nawawi in his marvelous book, Riyadu al-Salihin. Very, very useful in this regard. And I will tell you the catch in this hadith. Number one, a hadith which is agreed upon its authenticity. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that whenever the person performs a proper wudu at home, then he leaves his house to perform the salah in congregation in the masjid with the condition, لا يخرجه إلا الصلاة. Nothing really took him out of his house or drove him out of his house except to pray or attend the prayer in the masjid. كانت خطواته. Then in this case, his footsteps, each one of his footsteps would erase one of his sins and raise him in ranks 1 degree higher. So he will earn a good deed and have one of his sins being erased for each one of his steps that he's taken towards the masjid. This is number one. Number two, as he arrives to the masjid, when he sits waiting for the prayer, he is in the prayer. So he's not actually praying, but he offered his tahiyatul masjid or the voluntary prayer before the prayer, and he's sitting, waiting. فهو في صلاة ما دامت تحبسه الصلاة. As long as he's waiting for the fard namaz, he is considered as if he's actually praying. Then after he prays, as long as he's sitting in the same place after the prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appoints some angels to pray for him. As long as he's sitting, he did not lose his wudu, did not violate his sitting by talking about others in a bad way, did not commit any sins. So the set of angels who are surrounding him, they keep praying for him. They say, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahumma ghafillah, Allahumma arham. Oh Allah, forgive him his sins. Oh Allah, have mercy on him. The catch in this hadith is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يخرجه إلا الصلاة. He did not leave his house but to pray. He only came to pray. So he gets a set of package of reward because of that. Who knows about the sincerity of any person? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, no one whatsoever has the right to judge anybody's heart or anybody's sincerity, because that's only up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one has this access but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the other hadith, also in the same chapter, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ أَجِسَامِكُمْ وَلَاكِ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ. Allah does not look in a way of evaluating and appraising you, does not look at your images and your body build, rather he only looks at your hearts. So you know whether you're sincere or not, because you are the one who formulated the intention. No mullah, no imam, no one whatsoever can tell whether you are sincere or not. Only if you are sincere, you know, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obviously knows that, then you will be rewarded for that. You cannot judge anybody's sincerity. Wallahu ta'ala a'la wa a'lam.